Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished citizens, well-wishers, elders, the youth in Bangladesh and abroad, whoever like and love Bangladesh, for them this is a very short video presentation, submission from Sayyid Muhammad Ibrahim. Indeed, I am retired Major General Sayyid Muhammad Ibrahim Birpati, Chairman of Bangladesh Kalyan Party, which is a registered political party of Bangladesh, a member of the alliance, 20-party alliance, under the leadership of BNP of Begum Khaleda Zia. I have taken part in the 11th parliamentary election held or being held on the 30th of December 2018. My symbol has been the paddy sheaf, Dhanir Sheesh, which I show you again. This is a ballot paper where a voter had put the seal on paddy sheaf in Bangla, Dhanir Sheesh. Dhanir Sheesh is the traditional, historic, valuable, praiseworthy symbol of Bangladesh Nationalist Party, BNP. And BNP had given me the nomination on behalf of the 20-party alliance. I'm grateful to them. I've taken part in the campaign or publicity for nearly 18 days in full, from the evening of 10th of December till very early morning of the 28th of December. Before I pass my comment on why I withdrew myself from the election, let me give a 2-minute background. The BNP in my constituency has a number of senior leaders. I'm grateful to all of them for having accepted me, having instructed their own followers, and I'm grateful to the 20-party alliance leaders for having accepted me and having given instruction to their followers to take part. I explained for those who don't know intimately the political system in the country that I am the chairman of Bangladesh Kalyan Party, but I'm taking part in election with the symbol of BNP, which is allowed under our law. There are a number of aspirants for this very symbol to take part in the election, but the alliance gave it to me, and I'm grateful to the alliance, and I'm grateful to the leaders who have accepted it. And the grassroots members of the BNP and the 20-party alliance have been excellent, have been so cooperative, so hardworking, so determined that my language in English, my capabilities in English, failed to express it in full. Let me submit to the world at large that I have been a freedom fighter in 1971, fighting for Bangladesh independence. One of the main reasons was we respected democracy, but the military government of Pakistan in 1971 disrespected the results of the vote, which was held in December 1970. They declined to honor the mandate of the people. Thus, we had to fight. We became an independent nation. With a broken heart, with an agitated mind, a soldier, a former retired Major General, a gallantry award holder, submits to the world at large. The present environment in Bangladesh does not tolerate democracy. And the government or the ruling party, the party in power, is mainly responsible for it. I'm sorry to say so. I own Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. I own Mr. Tajuddin Ahmed and Sayyid Nazrul Islam. I own the then Colonel M.A. Usmani. And I own the then Major Ziaur Rahman Birut later President Zia-ur Rahman, Shaheed President Zia-ur Rahman Bir Uttam, because of their leadership, because of their role in the independence war. But the ruling party doesn't accept the way we do. They are not as liberal as we are. They are not as realistic as we are. However, coming back to the decade from 2008 to 2018, BNP and its allies took part in the election of 2008. I was not an ally. I took part in the election on my own. I was defeated. Our party had given 36 candidates. We lost. We were only three weeks old party. 3 weeks to take part in election. We happily accepted defeat because the election was reasonable. In 2014, our 20-part alliance did not take part in election because of the political constraints, adversarial conditions. In 2018, the 20-party alliance under the leadership of BNP and the Jati Yoke Front under the leadership of Dr. Kamal Hussain decided to take part in the election. We happily decided to take part in the election. I, retired Major General Sayyid Muhammad Ibrahim, Chairman Bangladesh Kalyan Party, a loyal member of the alliance, also decided to take part in the election. And the election was held today. Ladies and gentlemen, dignitaries, excellencies, fellow brothers, sisters, whoever love democracy, I submit to you, I am a graduate of the British Staff College at Camberley in 1982 and 83, and a graduate of the United States Army War College in Pennsylvania, 89-90. This is not democracy that I learned. In 1991, the Chief Justice of Bangladesh, Mr. Justice Shahabuddin Ahmad, was the acting president of the country, and he ordered the bureaucracy and the Bangladesh military to conduct an election, and that was a modern election. I was the contact person to face the civil administration for all cooperation, joint actions, and the election was lauded worldwide. Why? Because we did it under a neutral environment. We wanted to give the people a chance to take part in the election. 2018 has been so different. My constituency is called Chittagong 5. It contains or it includes the whole of the Upazila Hat Hazari, and it includes 2 wards of the Chittagong City Corporation, ward number 1 and ward number 2. I had 2 assistant returning officers. One was located in Hat Hazari, the UNO, and the other was located in Pachalaish, the Thana Nirbachan Karmakarta, Thana election officer. During the election campaign, 2 times assault was made on my life. I just faced death in moments. It came in surprise from supporters of my political adversary. And their mark was plow in Bangla Langol. I will not blame any individual by name, but somebody has to take the responsibility. History will speak of it. But I submit to you, education, family background, culture, and political aspirations together make a man, his outlook, and his activities. I submit during the political campaign for the election, we had severe limitations. We could not go to many places because of security hazards, likely threats to my life, likely threats to the life of my colleagues and workers. Yet we tried to send our message to the entire community. We always preached patience. We always preached fellow living. We always preached cohabitation. So we live together. We preached no vengeance. We preached no revenge. We aspired, we appealed for an opportunity for people to vote on the 30th of December. But the world will come to know in details I write in Bangla language dailies. I will write in English language dailies also. And I'll continue to speak. I'm not very well known to the diplomatic community. I'm reasonably known to the diplomatic community. I'll communicate with them. It is my duty on behalf of my nation to let the world know what happened. What happened? On the 29th of December, between 6 p.m. and midnight 12, which amounts to 12 a.m. 00:00 hours of the 30th of December, massive terrorization took place in almost two-thirds of the area of my constituency. Supporters of my adversary, which can the symbol plow, langol, in many cases, in many places, with direct support of law enforcing agencies, went and occupied polling centers. They took control of the area, the building, the materials. What are the materials? Dear sir, dear ladies, this is a ballot paper. 100% ballot papers for every polling center are packed and sent to every polling center the night before. We had appealed long time ago that ballot papers should not be sent from the Upazila headquarters to the polling centers during the night time or the night before. Why? Because we knew hooligans, terrors, mastans, musclemen will be used. They will occupy the building. They will take hold of blank ones. They will put seals. Put them into the boxes. Seal the boxes. Exactly that was done in nearly a huge area of my constituency. From 6 p.m. yesterday to midnight, almost 2 o'clock, when I was awake, we continued to receive messages on mobile phone from people, what is happening in their respective area. People are being beaten, people are being thrown away from their houses, they were being threatened with life, then leave this village and get lost. Go away from here, don't come here till the 1st of January, or you will be killed, you will be sorted out. Forget, I would like to forget the minor offenses. All my political campaign offices were burned down, pulled down, posters, banners were pulled down, torn away. Whoever were working for publicity on a three-wheeler with public address equipment, mics, were beaten. Their heads broken, legs broken, hands broken. Their women tortured. Their paddy fields tortured, destroyed. Their homesteads destroyed. It's almost like scorched earth policy that in battlefield people take. Under these circumstances, people were very scared. Yet, because in the last 10 years, they did not get an opportunity to cast vote, particularly 30% of the voters, approximately, were first-time voters. They wanted to vote. We appealed to them, come and vote. Now, let's come back to what happened today. I'm speaking to you from 4:15 p.m. Now it's almost 4:29 p.m. It's getting a little long. But bear with me, dear sirs, dear ladies. You'll never get a first-hand explanation like this from a soldier turned political worker. My email, mgsmibrahim@gmail.com. You can communicate with me. Okay. I've spoken in Bangla number of times today. Last one was approximately 3:30 p.m. today. It's on my timeline, Facebook ID. This is in English for the world community and those who find it difficult. And you'll also listen to it only when in Bangladesh the internet is restored. It 3G, 4G, no more belongs in Bangladesh now. Otherwise people will let the world know what is happening instantly. What happened then? From 8 o'clock this morning, people were up in the voting centers. Agents of Padishi, Dhaneshish, were not allowed to enter. Somehow, few managed to enter, and soon they were thrown away out. Voters who are known in the locality as supporters of Dhanashish were not allowed to enter, were not allowed even to queue up, to stand in the queue. Those who managed somehow to enter, stand in queue and enter a polling room, voting room, were handed over sealed ballot papers in many, many centers. It's already sealed for Langol, the plow. And they were told to put it in the box. And only few boxes were left open because most of them were already filled up from yesterday. Dear sirs, you saw what happened on the 5th of January 2014. Media could report. This time, so much of restriction on the media. Gagging. No photography allowed. No mobile photography allowed. No camera allowed inside. How will the world know? 28 television channels or 30 television channels operate from Dhaka. Most of the owners belong to ruling political party of the country. They are bound to obey the decision of the ruling political party because it was a favor given to them that you own a television channel but you serve the party. I am sorry that I am saying so. My political career is not too long. My party was born on the 7th, on the 4th of December 2007, and this is 4th of December 2018 plus about 27 days. 11 years and 27 days is the age of my party. Immaterial. I have been an observer of political activities. I have been an election observer in 2001, and from 1970 to 1996, as a military officer in various ranks, I have been involved with all elections, providing security to the people. Let me submit to you, ladies and gentlemen, dear sir, people of the world, Bangladesh Army was deployed in this election in the name, under the garb of a theory called they will be acting as a striking force. Where will they strike? Officially, they will strike at a place where there is so much of turbulence and violence that local police or BJP cannot manage. My dear sir, I am not a fool, but the government thinks half of Bangladesh is full. If the violence is created by the ruling political party, what the hell on earth is law enforcing agencies going to do? And the military has been told, you will not move an inch unless you are called upon by a magistrate or the assistant returning officer or the returning officer. It has been a ploy. It has been a deception of historically huge deception of Second World War type. People have been told, we are deploying the military for your sake, for your security, but the military has not been allowed to operate. As a former military man, I feel sad. As one of the founding soldiers of Bangladesh Army, fighting for 9 months in 1971, from which the army was born, I feel sad that the army will have to take this legacy on. I will not blame the whole army. They only obey. In a political regime, in a democratic regime, the army obeys. The army does not bend, it breaks. The army of the Pakistan broke on 26th March 1971. The army of Bangladesh saved the country on 7th of November 1975. The chief of the army broke on 24th of March 1982. I go no more. Let me submit. I am in favor of the honor and dignity of the beloved army of Bangladesh. But I must submit, I must submit, I must submit. They are being put into a huge burden of dissatisfaction that they could not stand by the common people. Common people are not foolish. Education and literacy level of people is much high. And being a former soldier, now Ibrahim, and now a candidate in Chittagong 5 constituency. It has been a huge pressure, a burden on me, saying, you are a military man. Why doesn't the military come and help the people? Why don't you request the military? I knew I am a political worker of the opposition camp. I thank the administration in power for those who have been honest and cooperative. I thank them. I cannot afford to thank everybody because I have identified who have been malicious, who have been corrupt, but no mention by name. I would like to end here. Dear sirs, I have declared my disassociation, my non-acceptance of the election at 2:55 p.m. Bangladesh Standard Time because I could not call a press conference instantly. I did so by a live expression on Facebook. In 10 minutes, NTV and SATV camera was here in my office. They took the statement. I make it clear to the world through this English version also that I had disassociated myself from the election. In Bangla language, Ami Nirbachon Borjon Korlam. For the reasons as follows. The grassroots people of Hathajari or Chittagong 5 said, we will not take this burden, take this blame, take this black scar on democracy in the name of taking part in election, because it has not been an election. I honor the opinion of grassroots people of this country. So at 2:55 p.m. I decided not to be a part of it anymore. I thank all the voters of this constituency, particularly those who love Paddy Sheep, Thane Sheep. I thank political leadership of BNP in Chittagong 5. I thank Alim Ulama, the religious leadership, particularly Allama Ahmad Shafi, Damat Barakatuhum, Peer Tariqat, Hazrat Maulana, Azizul Al Qadri, Maddatul Ulul Ali, Allama Junayat Babu Nagari, Damat Barakatuhum, and outside Hadadari, Peer Tariqat, Allama Nur Islam Hashemi, Maddatul Ulul Ali, and their followers. I again thank two more aspiring candidates whose nomination was valid, three of them rather, who decided to withdraw in my favor and instructed all the religious personalities, students, persons to support Paddy Sheep or Ibrahim. They are Maulana Nasiruddin, Mufti Shahabuddin, and Maulana Idris. They had put in tremendous hard work. So I end my gratitude to BNP, 20 Party Alliance, and all people of Chittagong 5, and my colleagues who were a member of my team for last 21 days intimately. Any mistakes, any offense, pardon me. I apologize. They were all unintentional. To the media, a big thank you. You have been a part of my team. You have honored the people by letting them know what is happening. Allah Hafiz. And my family, well, my wife, my children, my son and daughter, my brother-in-laws, my sisters and brothers, my cousin sisters, my distant and near relations, all have acted like a very close member. And I have a very important team. I'm not intentionally naming them. Very close team. For the last 7 years, I have plowed around this constituency and they have been a helping hand. I will be with them. I will be with the people. Thank you, sir. Allah Hafiz. Best of luck. Ladies, gentlemen, dear sirs, excellencies, all over the country, all over the world, who love Bangladesh, who love Paddy Sheep, who love a freedom fighter, a Birpati. Assalamu alaikum.